Good morning, Rabboisai. Ah! Change it up a little bit. Aha! Here's Shlomi Sobel. This is going to be my first sim, he says, that I ever made. And that I really enjoy learning. Here he is. I have a pretty long email here. You know, before I go to the email, I just want to announce, because we're doing siyumim. In Los Angeles, there's going to be a siyum on Shabbos, 8:30 at Shlomo Lazarian's place. In the Five Towns, Kalman, Yismach Moshe, Monday, 7:30. Manchester, Sunday at 8 o'clock at 8. Milton Road. Muncie, Tinek and Passaic are together in Wesley Hills. Matzi Shabbos at 8:30 at Beis Yehuda. Flatbush, I don't know the exact details for Flatbush. They sent me, I couldn't figure it out. Waterbury, by the way, that whole video of Wolf and that other guy learning the empty base measures at 1 in the morning, that was in Waterbury. It's a different Chabura. Waterbury, Thursday, November 11th at 8:30. So this one is Mamish Magdimim, Zrizi Magdim, Thursday, November 11th, 8:30 at the Gwertzman home. Over here in Bet Shemesh, Ramah Bet Shemesh, we're doing it next door. First is going to be Shir at 7:30 at night. And then the Siyum next door at Prushim. We're going to be a little bit more, you don't have to worry. If you're paying, there'll be food this time because the 60 people that didn't pay last time to come in are not coming this time. There's going to be somebody at the door. You have to pay. You have to, even if you need a payment arrangement, it has to be arranged. You can't just walk in. Everybody... There's going to be Masuda this time. All right, let me just read this email quickly. Oh, the sponsorships for Siyum. Bill Kamiansky is the first sponsor for 1,000 shekel because his son finished Rosh Hashanah. Mishnayis. Givaldik, if anybody wants to sponsor, there's still available sponsorships. By Peretz. Chaim Levine. This is a very long one. We'll try to skip around here at the very most important parts of it. I have twice tried to finish Shas with Daf Yomi, but not able to bring the ball to the end zone. The first time I tried with Chavrusa, and I lasted until the middle of Bava Basra. The second time I learned by myself, was able to cover a lot more ground. Rabboisai, I am trying to read here something. And I have a hard time reading as is. Whenever I fell a little behind, I would write down the Dapim. Bekitzer. My plan was that once Siyum HaShas came around, I'd fill in the gaps. So he made it to MetLife, but a mensch tracht und got lacht. After the Siyum, he came down with a terrible case of COVID. He didn't need to be hospitalized, but it took away his ability to concentrate. Bekitzer, after Pesach, it went away, but he just couldn't learn. He was toying with the idea of just going back to the regular daf. He couldn't do it. During the summer, I noticed a lot of ads with the free Gemara. I don't need a free Gemara, but why not? Let's join. Ellie Stefanski Shir. Bekitzer, he's a little bit of a, he knows people from the Shir. Noach Mermelstein, a close friend of mine. White Rock Bungalow, the Dagim. Who else does he know here? I skipped a bunch. Okay, Bekitzer, so he dove in and he was hooked from the first Good Morning Rabboisai, Creative Electricity, my first shock was that he knows Nachman Seltzer. I used to learn with his father Bechavrusa during lunchtime in Lower Manhattan. I also collaborated with Nachman in part of one of his many books. Then there's Fishel, good old friend from Yeshiva, Yisrael Shalitsky, Chabura Monday night, Rosh Yeshiva, Yeshiva Torah V'das, Shalom Rand, local Kensington boy from local Pirche. Bekitzer, the list goes on. I felt like a fire had been relit in my soul. And the excitement for learning slowly returned. Your sense of humor had a way to energize me, keeping me alert and focused until the end of each daf. The special effects done by the MDY staff, I guess he's referring to Yosef, were fun as well. The visual aids gave me an unbelievable ability to chop the daf quickly. Bekitzer, he signed up to be part of the MDY WhatsApp groups and discovered the camaraderie that existed among the collective daf members. This was a chizuk by itself. I attended a Shabbos Mevarchim collective live shir. Rabboisai, I truly believe that the Olam should try to participate in these things. It's a tremendous chizuk for everybody that goes. Shabbos Mevarchim collective live shir. And attended, not you guys here in the room, because you guys have this, but the guys out of town. and attended the local Brooklyn Seum. I made a few friends, part of the greater MDY family. One of the highlights of learning the MDY daf occurred during the summer. By the way, if you want to know what this guy looks like, Peretz Chaim Levin, he's doing the daf as he's exercising outside, I guess in Brooklyn. Brooklyn, East 17th Street. This is Reb Chaim Levin. Okay, Tam Tchachem, they say. So, I noticed another, one of the highlights, listen to this. He's in the Poconos, goes to local minyan, and he noticed another person is doing the daf, and the guy came over to him to discuss the daf. It turned out that person was actually from Chicago. He started handling the daf together, he says, handling. He started asking questions and was quick to answer him. We went back and forth. I remember that day there was a particularly complicated multi-tiered machloikis that you had so expertly charted out, and as a result, I knew it pretty cold. This gave me an edge. See, you come to the shit, you have an edge over the competition. It gave him an edge. Bekitzer, he explained it to him, da-da-da-da, the rischa d'oraisa, he says, and I believe I emerged as the victor. Although we were both winners and we both enjoy the fact that two people, Kitsi tried to schlep him to the shir. I don't know if it worked. Again, the guy's from Chicago. There's no way he's coming to the shir. Again, I can't think, you know, of the brand you created, developed, and truly a Talmud. And I have become a Talmud of yours. I've already done a sponsorship, bought Gemaras. Listen, Rabbi said he donated a lot of Gemaras, but he also took 25 Gemaras, I believe, and he gave them out. I'll continue to believe neder, do so to the best of my ability. Be didus Peretz Chaim Levin. So I love when... This is a beautiful long email. Look at this. All the way in the bottom, you ruined it. P.S. Grow a beard. All this. It was perfect. Perfect to the last second. Today's shir, sponsored by Shmuley Hecht, F245, in honor of the Daf Yomi Committee, and all members, Habaz Torah, Lil Nishmas, my dear Chaver, Mordechai Shlomi Pinchas Tuvia, Ben Avram Moshe Peretz Neri Yar. By the way, today is Rabbi Meir Shapiro from Chicago's Levaya here in Bet Shemesh. I believe it's at 11:30. What a Balmidas. Unbelievable. He taught the whole Chicago, people that went through Ari Crown, all the people, including my wife and all my brother-in-law that all went to his school. They said, unbelievable Midas that he taught there. It was such a taiva to send your kid to that school. It was different than the regular yeshivish there, but people sent it because of the Midas. Mesechtes Rosh Hashanah is dedicated by Yossi and Esti Elbaum. Did I say this already? No. Le'ilu Nishmas, Beit Letzipori Bas Reuven, and the Schus for Shidduch for Tehila Sarah Bas Esther Leah. Parnas HaChodesh, by Yoili, Le'ilu Nishmas, his father, sister, and Shver, and Parnas HaChodesh, Reuven Klein, my mother, Nechama Bas Kolev, Tuli Feldstein, for the foolish name of my grandfather, Baruch Ben Fruma Malka, and in honor of Rebelli, your seed is still waiting for you, in Ramat Eshkol, Shkoyach Tuli, anonymously, Refor Shlema Bekarev, Chaim Ben Chana, who is Mark Ashkenazi's father, is in the hospital now, so have in mind, Chaim Ben Chana, an anonymous friend, put that in, no one you probably know. Zok Deila Gimar, today is Daf Lamed Aleph, which means 30 Daf into Mesechtes Rosh Hashanah. It's incredible. 30 Daf. So, here's a question I have for the Olam. We have Shabbos, 6 days, weekday, and then the seventh is Shabbos. We also have Shemitah, 6 years of regular, and then a year of Shemitah. What else do we have that's like that? That the seventh is different and a rest, a period of rest. Anybody? Huh? But that's not seven. Seven times seven, yeah. Okay. We said Shabbos, we said Shemitah. So we're going to see in the Gemara something very interesting. But anyways, we learned yesterday that when we don't know exactly if it's Rosh Hashanah or not, the Eidim didn't come yet, so what do they do about Shir HaYom in the morning? We had a machlokes. In Bavel, the Chacham understood the kilkul was that they didn't say anything at all. And Reb Zeira says that they said the wrong Shir. They said something, but it was for that day, for the Sunday, for the Monday, not for the Rosh Hashanah. Maser of Achabar Huna, on this idea, this machloikis. Tomish Rosh Hashanah Shachris Karev Kilchasa. No matter what, the first day of Rosh Hashanah, the Shir Shal Yaim is that of that day. If it's Tuesday, you say the Shir Shal Tuesday. Sunday, by the way, today's daf, we're going to be discussing the Shir Shal Yaim, why we say the particular Shir. We are all, what is it, 10 lines from the bottom of Lamed Amud Beis. Sorry. So, even if the Eidim show up and they say today's Rosh Hashanah, we don't say a special shiur for Rosh Hashanah, we say Tuesday. The Musaf Ma'awaymer, what do we say in Musaf? Harninu Leilokim Uzeinu Hariu Leilokim Yaakov. Let's see if I could get this in order here. This doesn't really matter, right? We know what we're talking about. This is Rosh Hashanah. We're talking about is Rosh Hashanah on the 30th, on the 31st. Eidim showed up, didn't show up. This is the problem day that we're talking about. What shir do you say over here? Do you say of Monday or not? Okay, now. Harninu lelekim uzeinu. What is that? That's what we say on Thursday, every Thursday. Perek pe'alef. Harninu lelekim uzeinu, hariyu. So this is a little bit of a trua going on here. And then it says, in pasuk, dalet tiku b'chodesh shofar. Okay, so it's very tsugipast. It matches Rosh Hashanah beautifully. Harninu lelekim uzeinu, hariyu lelekim yakov. B'mincha ma'oimer, chay l'ashem, yachil midbar. This is actually referring to the Kol HaShofar by Matan Torah, which they say a mashal that a king divorced his wife and he was going in the street and he saw there was a play playing something about the king. So he goes in there and he sees that they're reenacting the wedding of the king. And it brought back memories and he took back his wife. So too, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, when we remind HaKadosh Baruch Hu of Matan Torah, the relationship between Klal Yisrael and HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that brings back Kav Yochel, those feelings of closeness between HaKadosh Baruch Hu and Klal Yisrael. So we talk about the Kol Shofar by Matan Torah. So this is Chamishi. This is what we say, Bizmanenu, the Shir Shel Yoyim, if you're still in Shul. So what do? בזמן שחל ראש השנה ליז בחמיש בשבת שאשיר שלוי הרנינו לקים זינו ליום בשחס הרנינו. So then they didn't start off הרנינו. It's not a good idea to just repeat it. So what do? Elama oimer hasi roisi mi sevel shichmoy. So if you look over here, I know there's a lot of words, but right over here, pasuk zayin starts hasi roisi mi sevel shichmoy. So if this is Rosh Hashanah, you start from the red part down, and then afterwards you come back and you say it, so it's not repeating. If you said the whole thing twice, it's not so good. And if the Eidim came afterwards, after the first carbon tamid that you bring every day, then you say the entire thing, even though you might be repeating. Now, here's the question. Again, what are the two shitas? On that 30th day of Rosh Hashanah, did they say anything? Zero? Or did they say the wrong shir? Now, if they said something, so what did they say? They said the entire shir. They didn't know that it was Rosh Hashanah today. So in the morning they said Shir Shel Yom Chamishi. The problem is that because later on they found out it was Rosh Hashanah, they're repeating it. That's if you say something in the morning. But if you don't say anything, like the Chachamim Bavel say, that if we don't know yet what's going on, we have a big shiloh. It's right over here, yeah? What's the problem? It's day 30 to the previous month. But I didn't hear. They even didn't come yet. I don't have a calendar. I don't know what to do. Is Rosh Hashanah? So better don't do anything. Sheval Taisa. So you didn't do anything. You didn't say anything. So then what's the problem? In the afternoon, you're going to say this. It's going to be the very first time you're saying it. Elomai, you see from here that you do say it. It says the Gemara, not a good raya. My own recovery. Shani Hasam, top of Laman Aleph, Omid Aleph. It's not a problem. Over there, yes, you're right. They did say this whole shir. But it's not a problem. Why? Because what's the worst that's going to happen? The worst that's going to happen is they're going to say it twice. No, that's not the end of the world. Since I don't know if the Eidim are coming, I don't have Eidim yet. So let them say the shir that's appropriate for that day, which is the Thursday, Harninu. What's the worst thing? So let's say it twice. It's not such a big aver to say it twice. Tanya, Rabbi Yehuda Omer Shum Rabbi Akiva Barishoin. Now that's it. So now we're going into why do we say Shir Shel Yoyim here? Finally in Shas, what is going on every day? We say a special mizmar. What's going on? So this I just I don't know, took off the internet. I don't know if I have Rishus or not. So don't look at it. Usually I have Rishus. It was out there. I'm sure the guy is masking that we should have an offer from it. He just won't print it. First day, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, light and dark. So, therefore, Barishom Hayo Imrim Lashem Ha'oretz Umloya. This is what we say, Mayriv, Rosh Hashanah, Hashem Aretz Umloya, say it every Sunday. Hashem Shekana, the HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the world, V'hikna, and He gave it over to man, V'shalit, but He rules it, V'ilamah. V'sheni Me'oyer, the whole mizmor is about Hashem is king, Hashem king, right? The whole thing. V'sheni Me'oyer, second day. What happened over here? Now, HaKadosh Baruch Hu ruled the world, so to speak, by Himself. Because there were no malachim yet that you could say maybe somebody helped. There's nothing going. It was HaKadosh Baruch Hu by Himself. Shalat by Lamai. Malachim were created on the second day. V'sheini ma'yomim. Godol Hashem u'muhulo me'oid. Hashem shechilak ma'asov u'malach aleim. He divided the upper rakia, the waters on top and the bottom. So chilak ma'asov u'malach aleim. V'shlishu ha'yomim. Elokim. It's unbelievable. Don't you love when daf yomi coincides with the daf? Here, mamish. Unbelievable. Yoyim HaShlishi. Here, we're learning. It's mamish unbelievable, no? It's a pella. Yeah. BaShlishi Yoyimrim. What? You just got it. Hill just got it. Well, he submitted a comment. Okay. Okay. BaShlishi Yoyimrim Elikim Nitzav Ba'adas Kein. Hashem shegilo eretz b'chachmosoi v'heichin tevel la'adosoi. So here you have on the third day, Hashem separated the water from the earth, so it's possible to actually live on earth. Without that, there would be no humans. If everything was water, we wouldn't be able to live. Hashem shegilo eretz. He uncovered the land b'chachmosoi. It's unbelievable. He contained these vast oceans that are many miles deep into one source, and they don't come over and drown everybody. And He created a world for His flock, for His Eda. And what do we say on the fourth day? Kale Nekames Hashem. What did Hashem create? Interesting. This is like a little bit shver. What did He create on the fourth day, on Wednesday on the fourth day? The sun and the moon. The problem is that people started worshiping the sun and the moon. So Kael Nekamah is Hashem is going to give a Nekamah to those worshippers. Kael Nekamah is Hashem. Hashem Shabara Chama Ulevona Va'asid Lipara Moivdeim. And He was going to take revenge those who worship them. V'chamisho Yoyimim Harninu Lelokim Uzeinu. Give it. It's a joy. It's a song. Harninu Lelokim Uzeinu, a mighty king. Hashem Shabara Oifois Vidogim L'Shabeach L'Shmoy. There's so many different birds. Now, if you just read this Gemara, what would you say here? Hashem Shabara Oifois Vidogim. Hashem created birds and fish L'Shabeach L'Shmoy. Who's giving Shvach to Hashem? Again, Oifois Vidogim L'Shabeach. So you would think maybe that it means that the birds are praising Hashem, like those books that they have, the Shira of the birds, the Shira. So Rashi says, no, it's human beings. When we look at the Bria, there are people, the bird watchers, you know, they travel to who knows where to see birds. I personally love birds. Don't get me a bird though. On the porch, you have like these, they're not hummingbirds here in Israel. They're like similar to hummingbirds. Little guys come and the big bird, pella play. You look at these birds, different sizes. That's what Rashi says. There's so many different types. And you look at it and you say, wow, the creation of Hashem. That's the Shabeach L'Shmoy. Bashishu Yoyimrim. Hashem Moloch Geus Lovesh. That's it. Hashem finished the creation. Hashem Shigomar Melachtoi Umalach Aleim. Once He created Adam, that's it. Bashvi Oimrim. Now, this is the only thing we have to pay attention really to. Well, not the only, but it's kedai to pay attention to this. Here comes Machlokes. What do you say on the seventh day? Oimrim Mizmor Shir LiYom HaShabbos. That's not a Machlokes. But why? Why do we say, you want to sing? You see? Mizmor Shel Yom Shabbos. This is the Mizmor that we say on Shabbos. In fact, if we have a Yontif or you have Chol HaMoed, that's all we say during Kabbal Shabbos. That's the only thing, if you come late to Shul, Kabbal Shabbos, it's supposed to say Mizmor Shel Yom Shabbos, right? But why? Says the Gemara, L'yoyim Shekuloi Shabbos. So the Tanakhama says, because it's referring to the future. Until now, all 6 days we're talking about the past. Hashem created the moon and the sun. He created the earth. He created animals. That's in the past. In the future, Shabbos, L'yoyim Shekuloi Shabbos, it's a day of Tchias HaMeisim. It's going to be a time of Shabbos. So that's why we say, Omer ibn Nechemya, I don't like that. Maro chachomim l'chalik ben aprokim alolu. Why? It doesn't make sense. Everything is talking about the past, and all of a sudden Shabbos is the future. Elaboration shekhanah v'hiknah v'shalbay lomoy v'sheni. Okay, this is freebie. We could fly through this because we said every single one of these already. Barishon shekhanah v'hiknah v'shalbay lomoy. On Yom Rishon, we say something that has to do with him creating the world, giving it over to human beings. V'shalbay lomoy, and he rules it. V'sheni shechilik ma'asav v'malach aleihem. He divided it, the heaven and the earth, and he rules them. V'ashlishi shegiloch eretz v'chachmasa, he uncovered the land. V'heichen tevel ha'ados. V'revii shebarachamu levani, created the sun and the moon. V'asili parama, Yudem is going to take revenge. V'chamishi shebar oifiz v'dagin shaberach shemai. He created birds and fish. Oh, fish. Not stop. Those beautiful saltwater aquariums. Fish. Why do people spend all that money? We saw Shalom Rand's aquarium on the video the other day. Spend $500 on a fish. The shaberach shemai. It's part of loving HaKadosh Baruch Hu, saying, wow, look at these colors. That's why I told the oil, you gotta go scuba dive. Finished everything? So we said, now, here it comes. That's it. Right over here. This is the Nakuda. Bashvi, Hashem Sheshavas. It's talking about the past, not the future. Why do we say Mizmor Shel Yom HaShabbos? That HaKadosh Baruch Hu rested. They come and give the Rav Katina, and this has to do with a different machloikis. Omer Rav Katina. Shito alfishne hava alma. And this comes to answer the question I started off to share with. What else is six and then a rest? Here we go. We have 6,000 years of humanity on this world. V'chad charuv. And 1,000 years of a churban. Shenemar v'nizgav Hashem. Let me just say it. V'nizgav Hashem levali b'yemahu. Omar Abaya, I learned from yesterday's Gemara. You say, let's do the Kiddush HaChodesh, and then we'll be done about it. So I'm saying it, and then we'll talk about the nig in a second. Omar Abaya, Trei Choruv. No, it wasn't 1,000 years. It was 2,000 years. Oh. So first of all, you see this idea of 6 and the 7th year is different. It's a rest, it's Choruv. The Bein Yada actually learns it's not like complete nuclear atom bomb destroying the world and this churva. Rather, he says that human beings are not gonna have that gashmias. They're not gonna need food. They're not gonna be materialistic anymore. They're gonna live without anything. They're just gonna go. They're gonna be oved Hashem for 1,000 years, 2,000 years without any kind of materialistic necessities. So, this is the machlokes. If it's referring to the future, well, the future is 2,000 years, not one day. You're saying, Mizmor Shel LiYom HaShabbos. Well, Yom HaShabbos makes sense if it's 1,000 years. But if you're saying that's 2,000 years, it doesn't fit into the words. It's not Yom HaShabbos. It's Yomayim Shabbos. So therefore, if you hold like a baya that the future, after 6,000 years, there's going to be a churban, then you can't hold that's why we say Mizmor Shel Yom HaShabbos. We say Mizmor Shel Yom HaShabbos on the past, not on the future. Future is 2,000 years. Stam derech agav, interesting, that there are cults. Just recently, there was a cult, I think in 2012. Many of them committed suicide because they made a cheshbon, the Mayans, whatever they call it, I don't remember exactly. They had a cheshbon that the world is going to end in 2012. And since, for hundreds, thousands of years, that's how they believe, literally for thousands of years. And then 2012 came, garnished, suicide. We're not like that. We know there's an end. The sixth that what? It did end for them, not the world. In their opinion, it was the world. Some of them. But Mimanavshach, they could have, if that's what ending is, they could have ended it 1,000 years earlier. Omar Abaya, fine. It's actually 2 days. The Musafei the Shaps of Mayo Imrim. What do the Levim say? What kind of shir? We have the Tumid in the morning, Tumid Shabbain Arabayim, but what about a Musaf? What kind of shir did the Levim sing? Omar Rav Onon Barova, Omar Rav Haziv Loch. Okay? By the way, okay, I printed this, so I'll show you anyways. God Hashem Mulam Oid Birli Kenu Har Kotchoy. So what does this have to do with separating? Because over here you see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is saying Har Kotchoy, Yerushalayim is separate than the world. So that's the separation referring to Yom Shlishi. Okay, fine. Hazivloch. Here's Hazivloch. Hazivloch is referring to Parshas Hazinu. And you take Akiva Solway, very nice. You started putting on film today, but I can't see the charts. If you don't mind going back for a second, or I could do one of these. Hazinu. So here in green, I don't know if it comes out well. Haziv Loch. Now the first four are separate than the last two. Why? In Parashat Hazinu, you'll see a lot of the aliyahs are split up. At least these four are split up. Six psukim, six psukim, six psukim. So the beginning of the Sheni starts Zechor Yemoisel. Beginning of Shlishi, Kiveyu, beginning of Revi. Over here gets a little, it's also Lamed, but over here it's Lulei Kas and it's two psukim. Fine. The point is, Rashi says that these, why is it Haziv, Loch, two different words? Because the first four are six psukim. The last six, this number five and six are eight psukim. Okay, that's why it says Ziv Loch. Also, I saw the Marsha says that Ziv Loch refers to Moshe Rabbeinu who said Hazinu Haziv. He had Ziv Ponim, he had a Ziv Loch to you. Okay, Vomar Avchonam. Vomar Avchonam Barova Omar Rav B'derech Shechalukim Kan Kachalukim Beveis HaKnesses. That's how the aliyahs are separated, just like this. And what about mincha? Now, did they say all of this in one Shabbos? Or every Shabbos they alternated? Perhaps, from all these psukim over here in Hazinu, maybe the Levim only saying the first six psukim of Hazinu 1 week, then comes Sheni, they said Sheni the second week, and then every 6 weeks, they rotated. Toshma, the Sanya, Omer B'Yoisi, Achari, Shoino, Oimeres, Achas, Shnia, Choyzer, Shtayim. Very poshut. For Musaf, we say this. What do we say for Mincha? Oz Yashir, Michamaycha, Oz Yashir. So it's three against six. So in Mela, it takes Mincha, we repeat the Oz Yashir, Michamaycha, Oz Yashir, twice in the time that it takes the Kohanim to sing the Hazinu, which takes 6 weeks. In other words, it's every week. That's what the Gemara is trying to point out. How could it be double? Why is Musaf double that of Mincha? Because it takes double the amount of time. It takes 6 weeks to go through the whole program versus 3 weeks to do the Mincha, Az Yashir, Micha Moicha, Az Yashir. So let's see inside. Acha harishoinoi meres achas. When the people of Musaf are singing one, are singing the six Aliyah is the sixth prokim, whatever you want to call it, Haziv Lach, Shnia, Mincha, Choyzer, Eshtayim. Mincha only says it already twice because it's only three prokim. The Kitzer, Shema Mino, Kol Shapsa V'Shapsa Amrichad. From over here, you see, they only said one chapter, not all of it, otherwise you wouldn't have the ability to say Mincha twice as quick as Moshe. Shema Mino. Om Rabbi Yonah Bari Diyom Rabbi Yoichana. Eser masois noso shchino mikroi. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the shchino, moved 10 different times to 10 different places. And we see this in the psukim, and we're going to rattle off the psukim soon. Okay, and when did this happen? Says Rashi, all the way at the end. By the way, Rashi on this amud is different than usual. There's also Rashi where Tosfos is. So don't think it's a Tosfos, it's actually Rashi. So the final Rashi on this Amud, Rashi gives us a little bit of an insight. that this part of the Gemara is talking about Bais Rishon. Kadosh Baruch Hu was in Galus Kav Yachol to 10 different places, Ukenegdon Golsa Sanhedrin, and opposite that, the Sanhedrin were Goyla, where in Bais Sheni, there were also Goyla to 10 places, and we know this from a Gemara, perhaps, I don't know, just throwing it out there, perhaps the Bais Rishon was about Ben Adam Lamakim, that's why the Golos is Ben Adam Lamakim, so it's the Golos Hashchina. Whereas the Bais Sheni was Ben Adam Chaveroi, it was the humans that were Nigla. Stop throwing it out. Esr Masois, Nos Hashchina Mikroi. So it goes like this, Rabbi, sorry. You able to see that? I don't know. How about now? Okay. So starting off, thank you. Starting off with the Arayin. And this is the Kapoiris. The Shechina, when it started out without any problems or anything, without, right over here. This is where the Shechina, the, what would be the word? Concentration of Shechina, whatever it means. The what?
Divine presence.
Yeah, but divine presence is everywhere. But this is where the Shechina lived. The focus, whatever. When it then, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it seems like, didn't want to just leave and disappear. He gave Klal Yisrael the opportunity to do tshuva, so kept them moving. So then he moved to the kruv, one of them. And then he went to the second kruv. That all happened where? In, it's not on this, you can't see it on the screen, but maybe, I don't know if he'll do us a favor, but right up here. Yeah. In here is Kodesh HaKadoshim. Sorry, right over here. Kodesh HaKadoshim, you can actually see the Aron. This thing is the Aron. This is the Holy of the Holy. Only once a year would a Kohen Gadol go in here. That nobody's ever seen this. Kodesh HaKadoshim. And within that, he traveled from the Kapiris, which means the cover, to the Kruv that's on top, to the other Kruv. So that's already three travelings. Umekruv leKruv, Umekruv leMiftan. Now, then Kodesh Baruch Hu traveled to some say over here, to the entrance, to the threshold, or to here. So he's over here. Umemiftan leChatzer. Then he entered into this area, right over here, the Chatzer. UmeChatzer leMizbeach. Here, there's two Mizbeach. There's a Mizbeach right over here. We're not talking about this one. This is where they do the Ktaris. We're talking about the Mizbeach HaChitzer right over here. HaKadosh Baruch Hu's Shechina was on this, on the Mizbeach. UmeMizbeach leGag. From here, he went to the roof. Over here, there's a roof on top over here. UmeGag leChoyma. Then he's on the Choyma, right over here. UmeChoyma leIr. Now he's in Yerushalayim. UmeIr leHar. Then he went to the mountain. Which mountain? Har HaZeisim. UmeHar leMidbar. And then he went out to the desert. UmeMidbar also veYashva b'mekoyma. And then finally he came to his resting place, Kav Yachol, and that's it. Shenema. Eilecha shuva el mekoymi. I want to go back to my spot. So he went back to his spot. Mikapar is lekruv, mekruv lekruv, umekruv lemiftan. D'chsiv, v'noyati lecha sham, v'dibarti itcha me'al ha-kapayrus. He was, HaKadosh Baruch Hu was me'al ha-kapayrus. This is where HaKadosh Baruch Hu spoke to Moshe Rabbein. Uchsiv, v'yirkav al kruv ayoyif. So it says, went on to the kruv. Uchsiv, uchvoyd al-kei Yisrael, na'al lamal. Rashi says, if one of these psukim is out of, is later on by written by Nevi'im, but it's still, it has to go in that order. It doesn't make sense that HaKadosh Baruch Hu was over here and then went back over there. He went in a certain order. Okay. Uchsiv chvayda al kei Yisrael nalo me'al ha'kruv ashehoya olav el miftan ha'bayis. It says he went from the kruv to the threshold. U'miftan lechotzer. And from the miftan he went into the chotzer. How do we know? Dichsiv v'yimoli ha'bayis es ha'onon v'ha'chotzer. Moles no yigek for the Hashem went to the chotzer. So Hashem on the Mizbeach. Gag. He went from the roof to the wall.
Here it
Here you see the har. Hashem Yekadim Leim. Umar Lamidbar, Dichsiv. So Hillel, how do we know that Hashem went from the Miftan to the Chatzar? What's the pasuk? I don't need to know. Don't worry about it. Dichsiv, Ta'ishav is bar, is Midbar. Midbar also Yavi Hashem Kaima. Dichsiv, Eil Chashuv El Mekaimi. Om Rabbi Yochanan Shishu Chadashim Nisak Vashkin Ali Yisrael Bemidbar. Shem Yachzer B'tshuva. You hear this? This is the Yisrael. That's why they say before. Baruch Hu is giving the opportunity, more opportunity, more opportunity. 6 months, according to Mashah, goes from Asar Tevis till the 9th of Tammuz. Those are the 6 months. From Nebuchadnezzar until the Chaima came down. Once they didn't do tshuva, Omar, Tipach Atzmon. Let them sit in agony. Shenem Arbeini Rishom Tichleno, Umano Yisovad Minhem, V'tikfosom Mapach Nofesh. They should have agony. Uchenegim Gosel Sanhedrin Migmara. Now, corresponding to the 10 times that Kosh Baruch Hu moved, so the Sanhedrin had to move. Milishkas HaGozes. So, Lishkas HaGozes is right over here. See this? This is where the Sanhedrin used to sit and be done. Unfortunately, when they had to move, they started moving around. They just strolled to different places. They did Nefashis over here. Milishkas HaGozes L'chanus. They went into storefronts. Why? L'chanus L'Yushalayim. Because there were so many murderers that they couldn't do it anymore. It was like too much. They didn't want to put to death so many people. So they said, we're not going to be done. So they went into these storefronts. They weren't done anymore. Dini Nefashis, only Dini Mominus. Ubechanuz to Yerushalayim. And from the stores, they went to Yerushalayim. Ubi Yerushalayim liYavna. This is why we brought this whole Gemara. Because of Yerushalayim to Yavna. That's where Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, these takanas that he made in Yavna. And from Yavna they went to Usho, they went back to Yavna, we turned to Laman Aleph from Beis, sponsored by Adam Vales, yeah? Yes. In memory, we have Yeshua Aaron Price here. I said the first day, he didn't know that Adam sponsored, and he's very close to the family. He flew to be Menachem Aval, came back, and said, he thought I was joking. His face turned colors, actually. Miyavne Leusho, Miyusho Leshafram, because Adam wasn't part of the daf until Yeshua met him at the Shiva house. This is what he does in the Shiva homes. He goes in there. Before I say, I'm walking Menachem, Rabbi say, anybody, you don't do the daf? He looks at the guy who created all things. Why don't you do the daf? I understand. He gets him to do the daf. All right. Umiyavne Leusho, Miyusho Leshafram. He comes in with a bunch of Gemaras. No, I'm just kidding. Anybody want a Gemara? Gemara, like, you remember those Breslovers in Bar Park with the Svarim? That's what it's going to be. Anybody want a safer? Yeah. Anyone a Gemara? Woodrun. I mean, Jay in the corner. Couldn't stop at a light without the guy coming. It's the same guy, by the way. It's one guy everywhere. He's in the pizza shop on 13th Avenue. What's it called? Amnon's. Everywhere. He never slept, that guy. Umiyavne l'usha, m'usha l'shafram, m'shafram l'beisharim, m'beisharim l'tziporim, m'tziporim l'tveria. M'tveria mukum m'kulam, m'tveria was the lowest. In other words, the lowest in Ruchnis. Shenema v'shafalto meres to daberi. Rebbe Lozo oimer sheish golos. There was six. Sanhedrin only had six, not 10. Shenemar ki heishach, that's one. Yoishvei maroim, brought down. Yoishvei maroim. Kirian is gava. Yashpileno, we bring it down. That's number two. Yashpilo, number three. Ad eretz, till the ground. Four. Yagieno is five. Ad ofer, till dust. Oh, Rabbi Yochanan, listen to this, Rabbi Yisai, a big Yisoid here. U'mishom asidim l'goyel. Dust. I guess it means, I don't know, maybe a person puts himself, anova, this is the gula is going to come from dust. Shenema isnari, mi ofer kumi. Says the Gemara. Yeah, what? Yeah. What? Turning over the daf, sorry. In memory, I didn't even say the first one. In memory of my mother, Gail Efrathner, Avigail Gittel Bat Pesach V'Chava Rivka. Sponsored announcement is Chus V'Shal Tamar Chaya Batzora T'Haver Fushnam V'Kare. I don't want to forget, but Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, it's brought down over here, that he only became Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, he started learning Torah when he was 40 years old. He worked until he was 40. So they say the same thing about the Saba Menevarduk, the Alta Menevarduk. He was working. He had a store, and I think it was Rabbi Sol Salant, or maybe Rabbi Itzla Blazer. I don't remember which one. One of them asked him, "Where are you running to?" He said, "I got to go make a living." So he told him a line. I don't know. I'll say it in English the way I could explain it. He says, "And where are you going to make for the dying? You're making for the living, but what about the dying?" and it shocked him. He says, oh, I have to do something for when I'm dead. I got to do it. So he opened up Nevardok. But until he was 40 years old, he was working. You knew about this? It's not how it happened? It says it over here. Rashi, no? The Gemara. Oh, yeah, Gemara. Yeah. Coming up. Yeah, I guess I shouldn't have said the story until the Gemara. For some reason, I forgot it's the Gemara. Okay, Zog the Gemara. Where are we? Mishnah. Sponsored by? I don't remember anymore. Official Mishnah. But is that, who's sponsoring the Mishnah? For Briny Yenta Bas? Dvaira? Something like that. Omer Yeshua ben Karcha. V'oid Zoy Siskin Rabbi Yochim ben Zakkai. Rabbi Yochim ben Zakkai instituted another thing. Shafil Rosh Bezdin B'chol Makom. If the head of the Bezdin leaves, he goes on a vacation. Shalayed Malachim Elo L'Makom Avad. They don't have to follow him. They go to where the Bezdin is, and that's it. Without the head being there, it's okay. Says the Gemara, there's a woman. Said, come to Bezdin. You owe money, come here. And he left. And she refused to travel. So he wrote a shtar to say that she's in Cherem. We see in our Mishnah it says you don't have to follow a Meimar. Look at these. That was only said on one particular halacha. You don't want these Edim to regret the decision to go to Bezdin because they're going to have to start traveling everywhere. They didn't realize it's another taxi. It's all schlepperei. So you say go to the regular local Bezdin. When you borrow money, you become an eved. You're meshubed to the malva. That means you go wherever he goes. Torah abana. Ein koyhanim rishonim lalaz b'sandalem leduchan. There's a gzeira, another one. That v'zu achas miteisha takonah shitkin v'yochanim b'zakai. That what? The koyhanim don't go up with their shoes because it might look, if they have to tie the shoe, they'll sit down. People think that they're not part of the kahal. Not part of the shoes. By the way, they say that Reb Shlomo Shvadron, I think he said it about himself. He said that, but also another thing. Remember yesterday I was complaining about the speakers that I hear myself? The speakers were on. He told me afterwards, the speakers are on every day. So you guys were looking at me like I'm crazy. They were talking on, I hear myself now. Well, that's not why you looked at me like I was crazy, for a different reason. Okay, what? They're on every day. They're on, I hear myself now. As soon as more people are leaving, it's like, yeah. Akabar Shlomo Shvadron said that he didn't have socks until he's bar mitzvah. Once he's bar mitzvah, he had to wear socks because he had, I guess, sandals without socks. Yerushalayim back in the day. All right, Zog the Gemara. Shizdai Pirko. There were two soldiers never changed their socks ever. They're not kohanim. Don't worry about it. So their commander said, here in the Israeli army, he said, gotta change your socks. So they came the next day, same smell, same thing. He said, I told you that you're gonna go to jail. Why didn't you change your socks? He said, we did. We changed with each other. Shizdai Pirko of Achadah the Pirko Kama. So what's going on here? This we learned. We'll just do a quick chazar because it's 8 o'clock. Rabbi Yochanan Zakkai was Misakin. You blow the shofar on Shabbos. You shake lulav on Shabbos. Reuven just got the joke. Yoyim Anef Kuloi. Also, you're not allowed of the day. The Tez Zayin Nisan. You don't eat chadash the entire day, even though in the time of the mikdash they bring the carbon during the day. You could. Eidus achoydash. What was Eidus achoydash, Rabbi Yisrael? Remind me. We just learned. The what? You go to what? No, that's later on. Eidus achoydash. No, that's Nisan Tishri over here. Okay, I don't remember anymore. Oh! Mikavaleh is what? Kolayon. Givaldi. Shkoyach. Mikavaleh is Kolayon. Mokim Vad that we just learned today, that you go to where the Bezdin is, not where the Rosh Bezdin is. Sandal Koyon we just said. Okay, this is Nisan over here. Mizumanim are working out. V'idach. Rabbi, I think during the Siyam, we're going to feher these guys, the Mizumanim people. Ask any question in Shas, or ask any question in Rosh Hashanah for sure, but ask also the Belzer and my Chavrusa anywhere in Shas. Shis, come prepared. Seriously, come. Think about it. If you're coming to the Siyam, come with the Kash and Shas. Shis, the high Pirko, v'chodah the Pirko Kamo, v'idoch the Tanyo, Gershon is Gai b'zman hazeh, so Shiyafrish, Roy Velikino, amazing halacha, that a Ger, who typically has to, like Klal Yisrael, when we went to Kabbalah's Torah, we had Bris Milah, Tvila, Karban, and Zrikas Adam. So because the ger, there's no carbon, so he has to set aside money for the carbon that he's going to bring, Meheri Bona Beis HaMikdash. Or Rosh Hashanah Lazar, Kranimna Aleh Rabbi Yochanan Ubitla, Rabbi Yochanan said, don't do it, Mipnei HaTakala, if you have money sitting around. By the way, Bizman HaZeh, if a person says, this money, this 100 shekels to Beis HaMikdash, it's a big problem, you got to destroy the money. So if you have money sitting around that's Kadosh, and the guy dies, and another generation goes by, they don't even know what the money, free money, they found a stack of money, but the money is set aside for a karban of the ger. Vidach plukta the Rav Papa, Rav Nachman, Rav Yitzchak, Machloikis, Rav Papa Amar, Kerem Revai, the fourth year of wine, the Machloikis HaMarayim, if it means all fruit or not, just wine, just grapes. Rav Nachman is talking about L'shoyin Shel Zahiris. It's not referring to the wine, it's referring to the grapes, it's referring to a string that we learned in Yuma. Rav Papa Amar, Kerem Revai. So, real quickly, the fourth year, you take your fruit up to the base of it's like mamish like Maaser Sheni. All your fruit on the fourth year of the tree that grows, you have to bring to the, you can only eat it in your shlaim. And if you want, you can redeem it for money and bring the money. Now, they made a takana. Takana is chachamim that if you live close to the Beis HaMikdash, one day's worth, close to your shlaim, you have to bring it, you can't redeem it for money. Why? To make the marketplace look like there's a lot of fruit. What is it? V'zui tchuma, elas min Hatzafayim v'akrav min adarim lo min amarev yadim min amizrach b'kitzer one day away. V'amu'ula v'itemi rabbi v'ar'ula amar b'yochanan matam kidi la'akir shuki Yerushalayim b'peres the marketplace should be full of fruit. V'danya. Kerem revai hoya loy l'rebi liyazir b'mizrach loy b'tzat far tovi u'bikish rebi liyazir l'afkiroi la'aniyim. He wanted to just give it away to the aniyim. Amar li talmidov rebi farnimnu chavirecho olav b'tiru man chavirecho. Who said that it's already muta? You don't have to bring up the fruit. They did away with that takana. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, see, this is one of the takanas. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, fine, let's stop over here. Rabbi, have a wonderful day. Don't worry about it. Anything we didn't make up, we'll make up on Matzah Shabbos. It's a very short daf. The night of the seal.